Hi, it's Bob Kraft of tennisministry.org. Today we're talking about Emmanuel Wimbledon Church and homosexuality. Wimbledon is next week, and in fact the church has organized activities to reach out to the pro tour tennis players, the fans, and the umpires for a number of years. They have organized a barbecue, which is a welcoming barbecue for players on their grounds. They've also had a meeting in a restaurant for players, and they have invited using former players who maybe willingly or knowingly or unknowingly understand the stance of what their church practices, and they invite recurrent pro tennis players under the guise of friendship to this church, to attend the church. So today I'm going to bring up the warnings on this. What caught my attention was the church leader, which is called the Archbishop of Canterbury. He is well known for encouraging homosexuality in the leadership, and it's been in the press, the media has reported it, and I had to do research. I went and watched video interviews of him, read his direct quotes, and I came to the conclusion that yes, he did support ordination of homosexualities into the church leadership. While he has been a little bit low-key on it, in fact, if you do enough research, you can find where he speaks what is really on his mind. And so from that moment on, I really did not want to encourage people to go to that church. There were other things that I saw. For example, it's known as a high church, a Church of England, Anglican church. That means you go to a church service from 9 to 10. You read from the Common Book of Prayer, which was written in the 1600s. In fact, I've stayed with people who have attended that church, and their church life doesn't really extend much beyond that particular church service. They're just good moral people, many of them, who attend church 1 hour a week, and the rest of the week it's not important. That's not a church that I want to encourage anyone to go to. But having said that, it wasn't enough for me to really speak out publicly against this particular church, and the homosexual issue is, and the fact that they are reaching out to the pro players directly. I would venture to say that the senior pastor, Jonathan Fletcher, if asked, would say, well, we in our church do not believe in practicing homosexuals being in the leadership. However, the next question would be, are you a member of the Church of England or the Anglican Church in England? And he would say yes. And then the third question would be, well, do they practice ordination of homosexuality and homosexuals? And he would have to say yes on that. Our ministry actually called the Bishop of Hong Kong, which is an Anglican church, in the Anglican church. It's under the Church of England. And we asked him that direct question, my board member did, David Moan. And the response was, it's up to each individual church whether they will ordain a homosexual into the ministry. And to me, that was the backbreaker for wanting to keep silent on this issue any longer. That means that those churches that are a member of the Church of England actually are in agreement with what they practice. Because you cannot be a member of something and not be in agreement with it, regardless of what you say, regardless of what comes out of your mouth. So I would like people to consider this, but then also we need to make it personal for us. You know, how do we feel? I understand the Women's Pro Tour, there are a lot of homosexual people on the Pro Tour, but on the other hand, does that mean that we have to hate them or to really speak out in a very unkind, disrespectful way? Absolutely not. They can practice that, but that doesn't mean we have to be quiet on what we believe or what the scriptures tell us, the Holy Bible, and not get into a verbal debate on that. The real issue here is, would you want your children or would you yourself want to attend a church where there's a senior pastor who's a practicing homosexual and maybe even engaged in a marriage with a partner of the same sex? What message does that send to your children? How does that line up with the Bible? Shall we take people to that church unknowingly who don't know this this stance from this particular denomination called the Church of England? In my opinion, absolutely not. And that's the reason why I'm presenting this to you. If you're invited to a activity or a function, a barbecue or a Sunday church on the park, which is what Emmanuel Wimbledon does during the championships, I would just politely decline it. Even if it's coming from a former player that you know well and you think has it all together, what happens is I can absolutely tell you that if they're going to that church knowingly and knowing that this practice is taking place, they actually don't have it all together. And you need to ask them that question. That's my comment. And for those of you who are praying, please pray for the pro players who are being enticed into attending this church service. And in fact, the church is looks from the outside looks perfectly normal. But in fact, the people dress well, they live in expensive houses, they drive expensive cars, they have good jobs, the church is in a very convenient location with a beautiful old steeple. It has a big billboard outside that they continue to put names of players on the billboard, knowing that the players are walking by or driving by or the fans. For example, Roger Federer is not God, something like this. And, you know, those are all things to entice people into the church or get involved in the church. Feel free to contact me if you have any questions. And I'm sorry if this upsets or offends anybody. It's not intended to do that. I'm not, if I was sitting next to a homosexual, I would not be angry or yelling or screaming at them. I wouldn't do that at all. The question is, if somebody is doing something where they're not being upfront and honest with you, that's a whole entirely different situation or question. And that's really what the church is practicing. They're not telling people that they sit under this organization that practices this among the senior leadership. Okay, thank you, and have a good time watching Wimbledon. I'll bring you some reports about the players and Wimbledon championships this upcoming week.